Let's talk more about Repo Man. Repo Man did battle with Crush. This is early stage Kona Crush. Purple, orange, yellow, blonde mullet, big jacked up Brian Adams. Brian Adams, correct? Brian Clark was...
I always have the chronic guys
yes,
there.
I always forget. Yes, Brian Adams, the Hawaiian ass kicker by the same name of the Canadian, singer. Vic, you lit up when I started referencing Brian Adams, the singer, and you didn't say anything.
Because I'm just laughing that we're actually talking about Brian Adams, the singer, because I start thinking of South Park, and oh, yes, we apologize for Brian Adams on many different occasions. Terrence and Phillip, sorry.
Listen, everything he
Summer
did,
69
he did
is a good song.
You.
Yeah, that is a good song. I do want to talk about Repo Man, since you guys talked about how, why does he have to like walk around and
snoop? Why was he so sneaky?
What about his attire that looks like a car ran over him multiple times? Like, that's not a very good Repo Man. He's getting ran over.
Okay, listen. I'm going to put an end to this right now.
Okay.
Because I've heard that question asked for years. Why did Repo Man look like he had been run over by a vehicle? There was a show relatively recently on one of the networks, a reality show based on repossessions, vehicles in particular. And generally, someone would kind of hide out in the vicinity of the vehicle that they were there to repossess. But 99% of the time, as they were hooking it up to their tow truck, somebody would come running out of the house or jump in the vehicle and try to drive off. So the risk for being run over as a repo man is probably higher than just about any career path you can find. So I didn't realize this at the time. I am just as guilty of asking the question, but as I've grown and I've learned, Repo Man's attire might have been the most logical of any WWE superstar of that era.
Was this happening before every match he ever had?
Yeah, like, what's the deal with this, Grace?
Never got new ones.
It's the gear.
Why did he wear a mask also? Okay, if the attire makes sense, why did he wear a mask?
Because he's
got
to be low-key, because if I go, hey, I'm here to... There's rules to repossession. There's
They're
laws.
Not spies.
But you have to be covert at times.
He looked like a bandit from A Christmas Story.
Yeah.
The Repo Man in real life does not come and knock on your door and say, hi, Vic, I'm here to take your car because you haven't made a payment in 9 months.
But a Repo Man doesn't wear a Halloween mask and walk up to the car and do it. They walk out, they try to do it, they hook it up, they leave.
You know what happens if
what
a
happens,
real Repo
Graves?
Man is a WWE character?
What happens?
End up looking like IRS or nails, okay? That's how, if you want realism, listen, just take the role. Repo Man had to pay his bills, okay?
Because when unemployment is up, my employment is up. That's how I make my money!
So when he wasn't competing in WWE, he was trying to repossess vehicles with delinquent payments.
You're really passionate about this, aren't you?
I am sick to death of people disparaging Repo Man and Barry Darso.
And you know what? It did pay the bills for him because he was able to retire and become a golfer in WCW.
Amen. Thank you, Dan. Thank
you. Well, you are hole in one.
Repo Man looked like he was out of Rocky and Bullwinkle. Like, he just kind of like...
100%.
Just the villainous guy sneaking around.
I'm curious to see the feedback on my explanation because I feel as though the ATB faithful will all simultaneously go, oh my God, that makes so much more sense now.
It actually kind of did, and that's why I was really angry with myself. Like, yeah, they kind of do get ran over, don't they? Yeah, they do run away with the cars. But still, it's ridiculous. Back to Dan's point, why is he wearing a mask?
He wasn't a great Repo Man. He just
obviously
was a Repo Man.
All right. How did they never have him feud with Thurman Sparky Plug and get run over?
Thurman Sparky Plug paid his bills.
That's true.
Save it for a future episode where we rebook some of that area, during that time as well.
Do you think the Repo Man translated to the UK crowd at all? Or were they just kind of like, oh, Crush is just going to kill this guy?
I'm sure there are people with bad credit in the UK as well. I mean, I don't know.
But did they have skid marks on their clothing and a mask over their eyes in the UK?
Listen, it all makes sense now. Just
Alex, I'm glad we're on the same page here.
You're welcome.
Accept
Thank you.
My justification of Repo Man's outfit, and the world will be a better place for it.
Okay. Well, listen to
it.
In
the UK, the tire tracks would have been on the left.
Correct, yes.
Like what you hear? Catch full episodes of After the Bell on Spotify. Follow us now and never miss an episode.